Hey everybody, Dog8798 here. This is my review and rant on the 8th Dragon Ball Z film, Broly the Legendary Super Saiyan, which is one of my favorite Dragon Ball Z animated films, and Broly is one of my all-time favorite Dragon Ball Z characters. I haven't watched this film in a while. I've just recently watched this film about four times ever since my router went bad, and like I said, I've been blocked out from the internet, and I've just been watching several stuff I've been meaning to watch and review, and this right here is one of them. Like I said, Broly is one of my all-time favorite Dragon Ball Z characters, and I was a huge fan of this movie back when I first saw it in 2002. I first saw pictures of Broly on the internet, and I was wondering when he would appear in the actual series, at the time. But of course that never happened. That later, like I said, I bought a magazine called Totally Dragon Ball Z or Absolute Dragon Ball Z. I can't remember which name it was, but the magazine I had said Broly first appeared in the 8th Dragon Ball Z movie. Then I downloaded the movie using Kazaa. I no longer have that file. I later, in 2003, purchased it on VHS, and I've had that ever since. And I just watched it. I've just watched it four times. Hold on for a moment. Here is the VHS of the Legend of Broly, the Legendary Super Saiyan. I think I'm holding this wrong. Something wrong with my camera angles, but this is the VHS tape right here. Like I said, again, I've just got done watching it four times. Like I said, this movie right here was one of my favorite animated Dragon Ball Z films, but man, it has not aged well. First off, I'm going to start off with the positives, then I'm going to get into the negatives. First of all, the positives. I love the artwork. The artwork is beautiful in this film. It looks slightly better than the television series because this is an animated film. I love the big budget artwork and animation. The animation is superb. Next, the voice acting in this film was pretty good from Funimation. I usually like to bash them because they, in my opinion, Funimation, when it comes to dubbing Dragon Ball Z, they suck, but they were good here. And next, I love the various rock music you hear throughout the film, and I love the remix of the Funimation Dragon Ball Z theme in the beginning. I don't know the names of any of these songs or know any of the bands, but they were awesome. Also, I love the comedy. The humor in this film was hilarious. Roshi transforming into his muscular, bulky form from Dragon Ball and fighting Broly, but he got too drunk that he ended up dancing and his muscles wore off. There was one funny moment where Oolong saw Broly, and he was running on top of Krillin's bald head and said, "Broly has me in some kind of beam. It was just hilarious. Then, of course, there was earlier in the film with Krillin annoying everyone with his horrible singing. Then, of course, there was during the fight with Broly and Goku and Gohan when Broly blasted Goku with a ki blast. You could see Goku's back on fire and Gohan desperately trying to put it out. That was also hilarious. And then of course I just love watching Broly yell power up, just torture the Z fighters and muscle them and throw them around, beat them up, throw awesome green key beams, and just laugh like a psychopath. I can't stand Vic Montagna, if I pronounced his name right, but he was awesome as Brawl, and he's an awesome voice actor. Now for the bad. The bad in this film is, number one, the story. First off, in my opinion, the story has so much potential. The first problem I have with this film is that the Broly character is impossible. As much as I love this character, the Broly character is impossible. How are you gonna be born automatically? How are you gonna be born Super Saiyan? How are you gonna be born with a power level that high without any sort of training? Without any sort of training under your belt? How? Then of course the Ultra Super Saiyan 2 form. If Broly is an Ultra Super Saiyan 2, then that means Goku, Gohan, Trunks, and Vegeta should not be any match for him. No, I mean, they should not have even won that fight. If that's Broly's power level, they should not have even won that fight. Not even with giving Goku all their energy. Piccolo should, as much as I love Piccolo being involved, he should not have been there either. He should have really been killed. So yeah, the power levels don't make any sense. It doesn't make any sense how Piccolo ended up giving Goku all their energy, somehow gives Goku the power to defeat Broly with one punch. Then of course you got next is Broly's actual character. As much as I love the Broly character, all he does throughout the film is laugh like a psychopath, which I like, and scream Kakarot. His character is weak and bland. And in my opinion, Toei totally dropped the ball with the Broly character. Broly's motivation for wanting to kill Goku is because Goku made him cry. What? You couldn't come up with a better story than that? It should be Vegeta he hates. It was Vegeta's father who threw him out and set him up for execution. But it was Goku. But, of course, it was Goku's crying that sort of got to him, like I said, crappy, terrible writing. And then, speaking of crappy, terrible writing, this takes place during the 10-day vacation during the Cell saga. If that's the case, tell me this: why would Cell allow them to go to another planet to fight an even more powerful fighter? Why would Cell allow them to leave the planet? He could have at least showed up there himself. But yes, another plot hole. And finally, the last problem I have with this movie is that, like I said, I think the Broly character had such potential. I still like him. I still think he's one of the coolest characters in the entire Dragon Ball Z franchise. But he had the potential to be a much better character. But once again, in typical Toei animation and Toriyama fashion, they just had to be they were more concerned with selling merchandise than telling a good story. This should have been in the series, in my opinion, with better story and better development. Because this right here, as much as I love this animated film, is one of my favorites. This right here, by today's standards, in my opinion, is crap. But yeah, like I said, this is one of my all-time favorite animated films. That's all I want to talk about right now. This was my very short review of the Dragon Ball Z film, Broly, the Legendary Super Saiyan. The sequels to this film, the second movie was okay in my opinion. I thought that was kind of garbage. That didn't fit in anywhere in the timeline. It was in the Buu saga, but where? And the only thing I liked about it was Gohan. Was Broly, of course, Broly being there, and Gohan fighting Broly in his blue gi, which he briefly Ghostly War and Naboo Saga. And then, of course, the next Brawly movie, Brawly, Bio Brawly, with the mutant Bio Brawly. That was absolutely the worst Dragon Ball Z animated film I've watched, next to Battle of the Gods. Well, alright, this was my review, this was my VHS review of the 19, of the Brawly movie. Alright, Dog 8798 out.